Thank you. Bach was stressed out about his job when he wrote that music. He was the court composer for Prince Leopold of Goethe, a great lover of music. Well, the prince's new wife was not a big fan of music, and Bach could see the writing on the wall. So Bach sent a letter to a prince in the German region of Brandenburg, wondering if maybe he had any job openings. Bach dedicated 6 new concertos to the prince in Brandenburg. That prince never responded to Bach. No call, no email, nothing. But the prince's estate eventually sold off the music manuscripts from this failed job applicant. Luckily for us, they were preserved. The 6 Brandenburg concertos by Bach. Great solo lines in the Brandenburg Concerto No. 1 by Bach, the piece we just heard. Peter McGuire featured on the violin alongside horn players Michael Gast and Brian Jensen. Osmo Venska conducted the Minnesota Orchestra on stage at Orchestra Hall in Minneapolis. Coming up in just a moment, music for string quartet and steel pianos. You're listening to APM's Performance Today.
Support for Performance Today and the music you love on Classical Minnesota Public Radio comes from you, our generous listener members. 7,000 pipes, some as tiny as a drinking straw, others as tall as a 3-story house.
Wow.
Laying in silent storage awaiting this moment. For the first time, the newly restored pipe organ in Northrop makes a joyful noise. I'm Allison Young, the Minnesota Orchestra and Northrop's organ, this Friday at 8. Broadcasts of the Minnesota Orchestra of Classical NPR are made possible by member support. Join today at classicalnpr.org/donate. Support also comes from locally owned InVision distinctive eyewear featuring handmade glasses and suns from independent designers in modern and classic frames. 4 locations including the new North Loop store on Washington Avenue and 2nd, or at InVision-Optical.com. This is member-supported Classical NPR.
Here's something we don't hear every day on Classical Radio. The steel drums, or as they prefer to say in Trinidad, the steel hands, born from the irrepressible spirit of human creativity. When French plantation owners in Trinidad forbid their slaves from playing drums, these resourceful West Africans found other ways of expressing their musical culture. They created a whole new tradition of wooden stick percussion, and later turned scrap metal into beautiful instruments. When American Navy ships abandoned tens of thousands of 55-gallon metal canisters in Trinidad during the Second World War, some enterprising locals turned that waste into music. Those abandoned canisters turned out to be the perfect raw material for what became steel pans. Now you can hear steel pans in all kinds of music. And here's an example. Music that Andy Akiho wrote for steel pan and string quartet. Andy Akiho and the Friction Quartet playing his piece called In Exchange. Thank you.
Thank you.
called In Exchange by Andy Akiho. Andy Akiho played the steel pans alongside the Friction Quartet. They gave that concert in Seattle, thanks to our friends at Classical King FM in Seattle for sharing that recording. Andy Akiho grew up in Columbia, South Carolina. He's a student of the Western classical tradition, and he's played percussion for West African dance companies. Akiho says many of the rhythms in his music come from that experience. That piece is called In Exchange by Andy Akiho. Our staff here at PT is senior producer Suzanne Schaefer, producer Megan Oglesby, associate producers John Goldman and Kathleen Bradbury. Our music blogger is Paul Fonfara. Our senior digital producer is Randy Salas. The managing producer of National Classical Programs at APM is Brad Altoff. The director of classical music programming is Brian Newhouse. Coming up in just a moment, music that came into being thanks to conveyor belts. You're listening to APM's Performance Today.
On a Sunday, my father occasionally put on classical music and we always shouted at him to turn it off because none of us wanted to listen to it.
About 10 years later, Celine Burns spent a year in Italy for her first opera and thought,
wow, that's something I'd love to be able to do.
Turns out she's quite good. I'm Melissa Alfie. Join me tonight at 7:30 for a live broadcast of Minnesota Opera's production of Puccini's La Bonte Day on Classical Minnesota Public Radio.
Support for the music on Classical NPR comes from you, our generous listener members, so we're offered a special today on the first day of the member drive. It's the NPR socks, available today only as a bonus gift. You get it with any other gift, like enjoying ClassicalNPR.org. Support also comes from Schubert Club, presenting Sphinx Virtuosi, an ensemble of Black and Latino classical soloists performing a program by composers that have been separated by distance, tension, and conflict. Music Without Borders at the Ordway on October 28th, Schubert.org.
At this moment, I'm feeling grateful for conveyor belts. In the early 1900s, an English gentleman named Walter Cobbett made a fortune from industrial conveyor belts. He used a good chunk of that money to pay English composers to write new music. Here's a piece from 1911, paid for by commercial industrial conveyor belts. The Fantasy for Piano Quartet by Frank Bridge.
Thank you. and be like, I can get lunch though. We'll get some lunch. We'll take a break.